my toxic ex. When I met you, I never knew what being completely broken felt like. I had it all, friends, family, and a man I thought was going to be my soulmate. But over time, you changed me into someone I wasn't. You made me feel as though I was never worthy of anything more than the pain you put me through. But I want to thank you, because if it wasn't for you, I never would have found myself. Your absence in the relationship made me understand the amazing woman I am. The fact that no matter how poorly you treated and spoke to me, I stayed by your side until I realized my strength. And I finally took the step to run away and never turn back. I never would have appreciated the life and happiness I have while you will always be stuck in that dark place, knowing I am that one hell of a strong woman that isn't embarrassed to have stayed with you for so long, because without the countless nights filled with tears, lies, and manipulation, I never would have found my worth.
Post a video of yourself where you were sad but nobody knew.
Just let it be. Why don't you be you? And I'll be me. Everything that's broke.
Girl, for that little nigga. Girl, for that little nigga. Cause you don't deserve that. Girl, you don't deserve that. Girl, you don't deserve that. And you can do better. You don't deserve it. You don't deserve it. You don't deserve it. You should do better. You fell in love with a fuck nigga. Now you feel like you can't trust nigga. You the one that would've stuck with him. Know you knew he was a fuck nigga. Why you let him do you like that? Why you let him do you like that? You leave once and be right back. Why you let him do you like that? You let him.
Yeah, I was really mistreated, and then I just realized I was better than that, and since then I feel like I've just grown to know my worth, I think. It's taken a minute and I don't think I'm there yet, but I'm getting.
When I look in her eyes, well, I just see the sky.
I don't love you, I'm just passing the time. You could love me if
to me.
That was fucking brilliant, Jen. Figure it out.
You told me I was fucking stupid while I was on the phone with my mom.
That was brilliant, Jen. And only somebody that fucking stupid would actually repeat that to their mother on the fucking phone. That was fucking
brilliant.
Do you think
that
brilliant.
You should treat me the way that you do and that no one should know about
That's
it?
That's fucking brilliant.
That you should isolate
well,
me?
Well, let me tell you what you ought to do,
If you're
Jen.
Not doing anything wrong,
Jen,
then...
you have 5 fucking seconds before I absolutely fucking explode. It's your choice. Get out of the goddamn truck now.
Why do you do this? Why are you doing this?
Get out of the truck.
Why do you do this?
Get out of the truck. Good job, dude.
Stop.
I turned around on me.
No, you did it to yourself. You can't even say it got turned around on you because you simply could have let it go when she starts sending a picture of herself to you. You should have... blocked her
right.
Instead of adding her on Snapchat and doing what you did behind my back to hurt me. If you loved me, you wouldn't do that. You
and
don't
I
do that to someone you love.
And I fucking regret it. Okay? That's something I gotta live with now for the rest of my goddamn life.
There's broken pieces till I'm bleeding. That'll make it right.
I'll rip the fucking hair out of your head and allow you to record it, and then you call 911 and it's gone. Come on. You think you're gonna fucking do that? Because I will rip the fucking... Ouch! Do you think that hurts you? Yes, I am!
No, no, it's me. Stop. It's me. It's me, Mike. It's me.
Stop, Jen!
It's me. You're not gonna hurt me. It's me.
Watch me. Watch me.
I would never do that.
Watch me. Jen, you have a decision. No, that's not true. The decision is already made.
I ain't tryna play no games, my love. I'm one of a kind, couldn't fake my love. Earthquake makes some shake, my love. Most of them can't even relate, my love.
Used to be gang, oh now you're not gang. Used to have fun, oh now you got shame.
Know that you are good enough. Please don't give up when things get tough. I know. Won't you please stay?
Let me give everybody a summary of what happened. April 25th, 2020, she ended up attacking me in my sleep. I ended up breaking her nose. She ended up flipping everything on me and called the cops. And before I was arrested, I gave the cops my login info for my security camera. I was like, look, watch this. It's all self-defense. Whatever, they held me for 2 days. I was charged with a felony. The first time I was arrested ever. It took him 2 days to go through all of the hours of footage and decided, yeah, this is self-defense. Let's drop his charges and let him go. She picked me up from the courthouse, and as soon as we got home, she was ranting and raving about the whole thing. Decided to go through my phone while I was in the shower. Flipped out because she saw that I told my mom that she's hitting me. I felt like it was going to escalate to violence, so I packed the bag and I left. I slept in my car for 4 days while I applied for an apartment. I was approved. We didn't talk for a whole month. She texted me May 20th and said, hey, this is hard, can we talk? She sweet-talked me, asked to see my apartment. I was like, yeah, sure, come over for dinner. She manipulated me. So she comes over. About 2 hours into the evening, she decides to go to the kitchen for a drink. Comes back, lunging at me with a knife. Chases me around my apartment. I lock myself in the bathroom and call 911. Cops come, she's arrested, filed a restraining order, still in pretrial.
I'm starting Bay's nightly routine. He only likes 2.5 pieces of ice in his water, so here I am cutting one of the pieces of ice so that it's the perfect temp to him. I have to make sure it's perfect and to his liking. Next, I have to go in the other room and call his gamer friends to make sure that they're ready to game when he is.
Hello?
Hey, Alex, it's Amelia. Chad's gonna be ready soon.
All right, for sure, bet.
Taking my slippers off before entering the bathroom was very important for him. I then turn on the shower and make sure it's at the perfect temperature for him. Not too hot, not too cold, but right in the middle. To keep his pearly whites, I wet the toothbrush and put 2 little droplets exactly where he wants them on his toothbrush and set it down. Lastly, I get Saint, his puppy, ready to be his emotional support during gaming. He made it really easy this time.
Did you know that who you love depends on how you were loved as a child? This is how it works. Your first experience with love leaves an imprint in your memory, and as you get older, you look for love that matches that imprint. So if you grew up with kind and supportive love, you will be attracted to partners that express love in a similar way. However, if you grew up with unhealthy and fickle love, you will be attracted to the same types of toxic relationship patterns. While you can't change who you're attracted to, you can change your response. If a needy parent annoyed you as a child, don't let a needy partner take advantage of your willingness to help. If a screaming parent made you feel guilty as a child, don't let a screaming partner have that same power over you.
Because I love you.
I waited for you after Chem Lab.
You were walking with Mark.
Because I love you.
You shouldn't be hanging out with that dude.
You should know how dumb that makes me look. I don't care if she's your lab partner.
Why do you have texts from him?
Because I love you. This number? Delete.
Because I love you. This Jason number?
Delete.
And Ben?
Delete.
Because I love you, I should smash your phone.
I'll let you give me your password instead. Because I love you.
I will check your texts every day.
You got lucky. Because I love you.
Because I love you.
You think it's okay?
Because I love you. You understand?
Because I love you, you stop talking to your classmates.
And you feel completely alone.
Because I love you. That's not love.